Romania. I would like to invite the distinguished chief of protocol, Ambassador Linda Sachs, for her toast.
Your Excellency, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, may I propose a toast to the President and the people of Romania.
Now we will have a very special performance of Romanian national anthem at a very special Romanian instrument called cimbalon, tambal in Romanian. I think it's the first time the national anthem of my country is performed at tambal, at least here in Australia, maybe in Southern Hemisphere. The name of our national anthem is called Wake Up Romania, and all Romanians around know why. So, enjoy. Other Australian institutions, friends of Romania, dragi români. I would like to start by acknowledging the Nunagaval people, the past, present and incoming custodians of this land. We have our Romanian embassy since 1991. I thank you all for joining me and my husband Dan for celebrating 2017 Romanian National Day, in particular to Romanians and Australians coming from New South Wales, South Australia, Tasmania, Victoria and Queensland, our General Consul in Sydney, Mr. Iulian Nițu. He's somewhere. This is for Romanian community. If you have some complaints, please. Mr. Nicolae Colorocaru, our Honorary Consul in Melbourne, Victoria. Be welcome, sir. Madam Ileana Corban, our Honorary Consul in Adelaide, South Australia. Be welcome. Fiți bineveniți la Ambasada României de la Canberra și mulțumesc pentru bucuria de a fi împreună cu ocazia celebrării Zilei Naționale a României, cea mai importantă sărbătoare anuală a României și a românilor din toată lumea. I want to start my speech with a little bit of history, the present, a glimpse of the near future and several acknowledgements. I'll try to be brief as much as I can. The past. Almost 750,000 Romanian heroes died during the First World War. In its aftermath, in Chișinău, on April 9, 1918, in Cernăuți on November 28, and in Alba Iulia, on December 1, 1918, millions of Romanians from Basarabia, Bukovina, and Transylvania declared unanimously the union with the motherland, the Kingdom of Romania. On December 11, King Ferdinand I promulgated a decree that approved the Great Union. The Kingdom of Romania doubled in size and in population. Later on, the year on, Romanian royal family, politicians and diplomats in 1919 worked together for the recognition of the Great Union by the peace treaties with Germany, Bulgaria, Austria and Hungary. The Great Union is a long-cherished national aspiration for unity, the foremost event in Romania's history of more than 2,000 years ago. The present. 99 years later, in 2017, we are counting in Romania 28 years of uninterrupted capitalism since the collapse of socialist regime and the success of the first broadcasted revolution, 62 years since we became United Nations member, 44 years since became OSCE participating countries, 24 years since we joined the Council of Europe, 20 years since it was signed a strategic partnership with the United States, no matter the name of the administration, 13 years since adherence to NATO, 10 years since the membership of the EU, still enthusiastic about it, and tripling bilateral trade with Australia during the last 4 years. Romania and Australia have common values and aspirations for democracy, state of law, freedom, respect of human rights, and shared prosperity. The strength of our committed partnership is durable in the military fields, either in the mountains of Afghanistan or in the dry climate of Iraq, or working jointly in the icy waters of Antarctica. Here in Australia, 2017 means the establishment of the first Romanian Honorary Consulate in Perth, Western Australia, and in Adelaide, South Australia, the progress of the long bureaucratic process of establishing a consular bureau in Melbourne, Victoria, which will benefit from next year to more than 10,000 Romanians living in Victoria, South Australia, Western Australia and Tasmania. I was also proud in August this year at the keel laying ceremony of Nineta, that means the Southern Lights in Aboriginal language, the birth of the new Australia icebreaker under construction in my native town Galați at Daman Shipyards. A remarkable achievement after 170 years since the establishment of these shipyards. But there will be more about Tasmania later on. A special remark for the scientific achievements of Professor Silviu Idescu, CEO Mesoblast and a worldwide leading specialist in adult stem cell research. The first Australian of Romanian origin, recipient of a national distinction from the President of Romania, His Excellency Mr. Klaus Werner Iohannis. And 1.5 minutes about the near future. My predictions. So the immediate milestones for my country, except going on with the excellent economic growth the current year, more than 8.5% higher, the highest within the EU countries, are: next year and the year after, we will celebrate 100 years since the Great Union. We will be admitted to the OECD. We are always paid as diplomats to be optimists, isn't it? A new mandate as non-permanent member of the UN Security Council for 2020-2021. That's for my Estonian counter, we are fighting for the same place. Thank you for being here. You know, I will have a remark for you, my dear friend.
Vote for Estonia.
You asked for it.
Well, we will see. Assuming the first EU Council presidency in 2019 and hopefully closing the business for the Brexit process mid-2019, there will be life after Brexit, that's for sure. And marking 50 years of bilateral diplomatic relationships with Australia next year and with New Zealand the year after, in 2019. A special word of thanks to my distinguished female ambassadors. And a special remark for advancing fair the cause of women in leadership position. Our female group aroused recently to almost 30 heads of missions, chargés des affaires ad interim, and heads of regional organizations accredited to Australia. I'm good with figures, as you may see. It is my strong belief that this new and noticeable diplomatic practice of an alternate dean as the dean of women heads of missions is an important step for advancing the gender balance objective and the woman cause. And I would like to thank in particular to the Honorable Julie Bishop FB, Minister of Foreign Affairs, Defense Secretary Frances Adamson, and Ambassador Lindal Sachs, for their genuine support in nurturing this new diplomatic practice, hoping it will proliferate soon worldwide. And now, the 2017 acknowledgements, after very careful consideration. The first acknowledgement goes to Mr. Julian Nitsu, General Consul in Sydney. I'm delighted to hand over the exequatur, actually the original exequatur, because he's already performing his duties in Sydney. But the originals are always coming a little bit later in our lifetime. And the best of luck in delivering your important duties for all Romanians living in Australia and in New Zealand. Your work together with the work of our consul, Ms. Daniela Stan, thank you for being here with us, is of tremendous importance. I'd also remark the presence of your spouse, Ms. Florin Nitsu. Thank you for coming from Sydney to Canberra. This is the exequatur. I bought it up.